Tutorial 2. How do I find a commodity code? In the last tutorial, we created a basic report on U.S. export data. Now, we will expand upon the report and begin to dig a little deeper into commodity-level data by looking at exports of apples. For users who are following along in the previous tutorial, we will be referring back to and building upon the report we created in Tutorial 1. To access this report, choose the My Reports tab on the Data Source Selection page. Then choose Tutorial 1. Otherwise, you can access this data in HS District Level Data Exports. Navigate to the top of the screen and click Report Contents. To quickly recap, you select the variables you want to include in your report in the Report Contents section on the left side of the page. Navigate to the Report Contents menu and select Commodity. Now, deselect all commodities. You can also clear your selection by clicking the X to the right of any report category. Now we will make our commodity selections. In UTO, there are three ways to select commodities. 1. You can choose a code manually by using the plus icon to drill down from the two-digit HS code to 4, 6, and 10-digit level categories. This method is ideal for users already familiar with the HS system. But what if you don't know your code? This is where the second selection method comes in handy. 2. You can use the search function to identify commodity codes. Let's say you are looking for data on apples. Simply type apple in the search box and press enter. We will select the code 080810, apples fresh. 3. Finally, you can upload a selection list of commodity codes. This method is ideal for users with a long list of codes. If you need further assistance identifying the correct code, you can use the Census Schedule B search engine for export codes, and the Harmonized Tariff Schedule search tool for import codes. Once you have made your selections, navigate to the top of the page and click Report. Now your report includes annual export data for apples in 2015 and 2016. When you have finished, navigate to the gray toolbar and select the Save icon, then choose Save As. Then save your report as Tutorial 2.